everyone, it's Vanessa. Today I wanted to make a video all about Lucy Nicely's works, all of the different graphic memoirs that she's published so far. This was mostly an inspiration, I think, that came from a vlog that I made a few videos ago where I talked about reading her brand new graphic memoir, Kid Gloves, about her pregnancy and delivery. So I checked out all of the other books that she's created and I wanted to talk about them in order to kind of discuss how her storytelling and art has changed over time and what are my favorite Lucy Nicely works, how I would rank them myself. So this might be a great video for you to watch if you're thinking about trying Lucy Nicely to see what book might be the most interesting to you. So Lucy Nicely's first book was French Milk, which came out in 2008. This one is a travelogue where you're following Lucy and her mother traveling in Paris, and it includes photographs and drawings and little comics of what that was all like. A lot of it is kind of just artsy, not necessarily like any story going on here. During the beginning part of her career, she was most inspired by her mother, and the first two books she published are about her relationship with her mother. This one kind of depicts all people in not necessarily like the best light. I think she's very honest, and also kind of the part of her life where she is in, where a lot of things are kind of up in the air and she is very frustrated by that. There's a lot of angst in this one, and I don't think this one is ever anyone's favorite Lucy Nicely book. I think this is just an artist starting out and trying to make a space for herself in this world. I would definitely would recommend this if you want to see how much she has grown in the 11 years since this has been published. This is light years away from what her graphic memoirs are like now. The second book that she published came out 5 years after French Milk, and that is Relish, My Life in the Kitchen, and this came out in 2013. This one also features her mother prominently. Her mother is a cook and a chef, and this is kind of an ode to how much food is important to her family and how it bonds people together. It's charming and quirky in many, many parts. It has really fun recipes too, and best practices for different things that you're trying to cook. If you love food, I think that this would be a really fun one to pick up. And also if you love looking into mother-daughter relationships, I also think this one is a great one to pick up. I think Relish is probably her most known work. I think it's the first one that went to the New York Times bestseller list that she published, and I think this is what made people start looking at her as someone that is important to this graphic memoir kind of field. The next one she published was only a year after that, and it is, I think, the first one that I read. This one came out in 2014. It's an Age of License. This is another travelogue, but this one fits more of an arc. You start in the beginning of a story and then there's a satisfying conclusion at the end. Unlike French Milk, which is a lot more scattered and just comics about different things and pictures about different things, I think in Age of License she had a story she wanted to tell and she did that from beginning to end. In this one she goes back to Paris. You focus more on Lucy being out on her own. Her mother's not necessarily a prominent focus in this one, and her trying to rediscover the city and in that way rediscover herself. This is when she's really starting to feel like, okay, this is who I want to be as an artist, and kind of still feeling some anxieties about that. There's also a lot in here about romantic partners and her thinking back about past boyfriends and having kind of flings. It has a lot less color than Relish. There's a lot more black and white in this one, but again, the first one that I read, so it kind of always will hold a special place in my heart. The next one that she published came out a year after An Age of License, and that is Displacement. This is another travelogue, but this one is completely different. This one is her taking a trip with her two very elderly grandparents on a cruise, discussing mortality, really, and coming to terms with what that means to these people that she really truly loves. She looks into her grandfather's past too. He's a veteran, and looking into what, you know, his whole life has been like. It's a beautiful look at this bonding experience where she's kind of stuck on a ship. She can't go anywhere, and the difficulties of her, you know, trying to be there for her grandparents but also feeling encumbered by them. And then last but not least of the ones that I have is Something New, which came out in 2016. Again, another year after Displacement. So she kind of churned them out there for a bit. This one is ginormous in comparison to all her other works. And this is where you can really see how much she has grown, I think. This is the first one that I felt like truly compelled to give it 5 stars just because of how complex and how big in scope it was. And also another thing that I really saw in this is her trying to not just look at her own personal life in a memoir format, but to also look at like the context of her decisions and to look at histories. So it's a lot more sociological in that way than her previous ones, which were just more personal. So this has the personal and the context for her decision making when it comes to her wedding. Something New is all about her getting back together with her longtime boyfriend. They were on and off a lot, and they decided, okay, we are ready to get married now. Showing us how she made her wedding a reality. All the DIY stuff that she did, but also all of the work that she asked of her family, how much they took part in the wedding planning as well. Wedding planning does not sound fun reading this. It sounds just daunting. And also her thinking about being a feminist and what different wedding traditions might mean to her as a feminist, how she tweaks some of those. It's really sweet, I think, to look at relationships. I like seeing kind of how people view their significant others and how they make decisions together about big things like this. It also has really cute photographs, which I always love when she includes actual photographs, and this one is completely colored, so the whole thing is in color, unlike some of the other ones that I've shown you. One that I loved and I devoured right when I picked it up from the library, and one that I would definitely reread, I think. Something New and her latest release, Kid Gloves, have a lot of things in common. They are about the same size, and they are about big life moments like this. So this one was about her wedding, and then the next one, Kid Gloves, is about her pregnancy and delivery of her first child. Kid Gloves is also, like Something New, very focused on the context, the sociology, the politics. I thought that it was also very touching, like many of her other works. I think that's probably one of my favorite things about her stuff, is that I feel moved by it. And I really, really enjoyed Kid Gloves. I've already returned it to the library because so many people are on hold for it. But it's one that I would also recommend if I would rank all of these. I think I would put Kid Gloves at number one. That's hard. Kid Gloves and Something New at number one. And then I would probably say Displacement, then Relish, then An Age of License, and then French Milk as my top in order of favorites. I'm excited for anything else that she comes out with. Between Something New and Kid Gloves, there was a 3-year gap, which is a lot to wait for, when I basically read Something New right when it came out and then had to wait 3 years for the next one. She's a mother of an infant and now a toddler, so I understand the time gap between that, but when she was putting out all the other ones like back to back 1 year each, it's hard to wait 3 years for a new one. But also just looking at the size and the scope of this book compared to the others, I understand why she's taking a lot longer to put these together, especially if she's coloring all of them as well. So yeah, that's what I think about Lucy Nicely's works. If you've read all of them or some of them, let me know your favorites in the comments, and or if you have been inspired to try one of her works, let me know in the comments as well. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye bye.